Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to be with you. This is the day the Lord has made.
Amen.
We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen.
That day next week, we're not promised that day. We hope it comes, but we could be there rather than here. And all those days that just left us yesterday and last week, they're all gone. So here's what we learned. Don't throw piranhas in your pool. What you talking about? What you talking about, Willis? Here's what it is. Jesus said, the worries of today are sufficient thereof. Most of us work ourselves into a frenzy and ruin our lives worrying about what happened in the past or what's going to happen in the future. Jesus said, here's your pool for today. Today's got enough piranhas for the day. If you got one or two piranhas in your pool, they can bite you and hurt you, but they won't kill you. But if you're grabbing piranhas from last week's and last month's and last year's pool and throwing those piranhas in your pool, and you're grabbing piranhas from next week and next month and next year's pool that hadn't even come yet, and you're throwing those piranhas in the pool, that many piranhas will eat you alive.
Amen.
So let's concentrate on today. Jesus will give us the grace and strength for today. Like manna, he didn't promise us next week's strength for today. That's next week. So church, here's what we're going to say. God's going to help me with this till I get it right. I'm going to stop throwing piranhas in my pool. Church, you going to stop throwing piranhas in your pool?
Yes.
There you go. Now we can say, this is the day the Lord has made. This is all we got strength and courage for. We're going to do our best this very day. And now after having said that, I have to make announcements for coming days. They're not here yet, but it's okay to prepare for them. Doesn't mean you're grabbing piranhas from that day. Tuesday is our women's Bible study. It's been going really great. The Rock, the Road, the Rabbi is our women's Bible study. It's Tuesday at 10. Prayer meeting is 10 o'clock on Wednesday. Excuse me, is 6 o'clock on Wednesday evening. We've been having good studying and great prayer. Our WMU meeting is this Thursday at 10. The 10th at 10 down in the fellowship hall. I'm going to call on Philip in just a second to make an announcement. Saturday, the clothes closet is going to be open, and we have a work day tomorrow, ladies, tomorrow, and not just ladies, whoever can help, we have a work day at the clothes closet, and that's tomorrow at 9 o'clock. So if you can come up and help organize, help sort, help get things ready at the clothes closet, that's tomorrow at 9 o'clock. Next week is going to be our quarterly church conference as soon as we finish worship. And everybody remember, when does daylight savings time change? Next week, next Saturday, okay? This is also our, beginning March 6th, our week of prayer for our Annie Armstrong Easter offering. And all those monies that are given go to help spread Christ right here in the U.S. So we certainly want to meet and exceed, if we can, our goal of $1,000. And finally, before Philip comes up, the big invite is a push to get folks in for Easter. You know, if there are times in the year when folks are going to come to church, it's usually Christmas and Easter. And the last thing we want to do is make people feel bad because they only came two times. Because two is better than one, and one is sure better than one. Exactly. So be inviting folks. How do I do that? You begin praying for them. If you know six families that you want to start praying for and invite them to come Easter, use this prayer card. What if I don't know six?
Do five.
Do five. What if you don't know five?
Do four.
What if you only know one?
Do one.
What if you don't know any? Pray so you can find somebody, okay? Everybody as a church can do something in inviting. And if they decide not to come, okay. Easiest way to get them to come, I'll come pick you up. And we'll get a biscuit at Hardee's and then we'll go to church. Folks like Hardee's biscuits even if they don't yet like Jesus. Amen? Right? Be wise as serpents, harmless as doves. So let's begin praying for our Easter crowd because from what I remember in this book, big things happened at Easter. Amen? Philip, come up. Talk with us, brother.
I'd just like to make a quick little announcement about Brotherhood, which is next Saturday at 6 o'clock downstairs. We have started a men's Bible study during this time. It is Authentic Manhood 33. Please, the ones that do come, I hope you all come. The ones that do come, please bring a notepad and a pen so we can start this Bible study outright. And we've done one viewing of it last time to make sure we wanted to do this, and everybody that was there agreed that it's going to be a great Bible study. I've already done it one time before from where I was with it. So I really love this thing. I think it would really reach out and touch, especially the younger men.
Amen.
If we could get some of the people who have younger children, your grandchildren, your nephews and uncles, whatever, just bring anybody you possibly can. All the time we bring if you have to. It don't matter. Well, we can get them later. But please, we are going to have hamburgers and hot dogs. So please bring condiments, bread, drinks, and anything else you'd like to eat, the hamburgers and hot dogs. Coleslaw, potato salad, stuff like that. And I hope to see all of y'all there. Y'all have a blessed day.
Thank you, Brother Philip. And yes, it is well worth your time to come to a Brotherhood meeting. We did watch the, I guess it was the first part, in kind of an introduction and layout. Very, very good. And if you're a man, you will be blessed by these video lessons. Also, I just have a very quick announcement. Pastor Search Committee meeting will be this afternoon at 2 o'clock. So you'll have time to go home, eat, or go out and eat. And we'll meet down, we'll meet in the library. We've got some business to take care of. So anyways, hope everybody can make that. If you can't, just let me know and I'll get you updated. So Brother Brother Ray, David.
Praise, and give him praise. Come into his presence.
Good morning. Let's take our hymnals and turn to page 407, Because He Lives, and let's stand and sing it. Turn right over to page 410. It is well with my soul. And let's sing first, second, and last. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever
with my soul. It is well.
Turn right over to page 412. My faith has found a resting place. And let's sing first, second, and last.
My faith has found a resting place, not in device nor creed. I trust the ever-living one, his words for me shall plead. I need no other argument, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. Enough for me that Jesus saves. This ends my fear and doubt. A sinful soul, I came to him. He'll never cast me out. I need no other argument. I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. Great physician heals the sick, the lost he came to save.
Now Debbie Wade brings special music.
This is one of my favorite songs. But when I ordered the CD and it arrived, I was a little disappointed with it because it left out a verse. So it's kind of a short song today, which doesn't mean you have to preach any longer, okay? Because we don't like cold chicken. All right. Okay. Oh, one more thing. Please pray for the people in Ukraine. I just feel so bad for those people. I mean, they're just leaving with the clothes on their backs and what little bit they can carry and the poor children. I just, shame on Russia. Yeah, okay, I'm ready. I am weak, but thou art strong. Jesus, keep me from all wrong. I'll be satisfied as long as I walk, let me walk close to thee, just a closer walk with thee. Grant it, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. When my life down here is old, and time for me will be no more, guide me gently, safely on to thy kingdom shore, to thy shore. Just a closer walk with thee. Grant it, Jesus, is my plea.